Shifting gears now, the University Grants Commission's diktat to all universities to celebrate and observe the Vallabhbhai Patel birth anniversary has sparked a fresh row. The UGC has restricted itself in merely sending advisories, has made it now mandatory for educational bodies to follow its orders. The notice suggests that universities conduct events such as Unity Run, plays or songs on the theme of unity, and essay contest on Patel's contributions. Well, that is the latest that we are getting. Now, the UGC has directed all the universities in the country to observe Vallabhbhai Patel birth anniversary on the October of 31st through a notice whose language implies a binding order. Now, but this has not really gone down too well, as many people are now questioning the order, asking why it is necessary, and certainly the timing of it coming very close to the elections that has been announced in Gujarat as well. More importantly, the HRD ministry is now authorized to issue binding orders on the commission under Section 20 of the UGC Act. But there has been a lot of controversy surrounding this particular notice by the UGC, which is merely a body there to give out notices as well, but to not impose such mandatory decisions. And that is something that has sparked a major row, because the UGC generally restricts itself to merely sending advisory. Now that body has made it mandatory for educational bodies to follow its orders. Shirin now joins me on the phone line with more details. Shirin, the UGC's diktat to all universities to celebrate and observe Vallabhbhai Patel birth anniversary certainly hasn't gone down too well, with many saying that the body just has to restrict itself from giving advisories. It cannot make it mandatory for educational bodies to follow its orders.
Well, that is right. The UGC, according to the UGC Act, the UGC Commission can only give an advisory to the universities and colleges, like improving the infrastructure, how to conduct the classes. Now, this particular diktat coming from UGC has not gone down well with the universities. This is following the Ministry of HRD letter to the UGC asking that they have to, the language of the letter was like a binding order, asking the UGC to make sure that all the universities and colleges observe Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel on October 31st. So clearly, the language of the letter was a binding order which has been passed by the UGC to all the universities. The universities maintain that it is now our right whether we want to celebrate or not is up to us. The UGC cannot force a particular university or college to celebrate the Sardar Vallabhbhai birth anniversary. So that is the controversy that has erupted following the letter that has been passed on by the HRD ministry to the UGC commission.
But more importantly, the timing of this particular order has also been a point, something that the opposition has picked up, saying that this has been issued ahead of the elections in Patel's home state of Gujarat. Is that also something that will give more ammunition there for the opposition now?
Well, that is right, because if you see the way that this government is going to celebrate Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel birth anniversary is on a large scale. Prime Minister has called for a run for unity where all the government employees and ministers will be running with him for this run for unity. So after this, we are seeing how HRD is also asking the UGC to make sure a binding order, make sure that particular day is observed in all these universities and colleges. Earlier, these notices which were sent by the UGC had a language as to requesting the universities and colleges to observe this particular day or carry out this particular event. But this particular letter had a very binding order, language seemed to be a binding order, which has not gone down well with the university. Now it is something that is going to wait and watch for if universities will abide by this order that has been passed by the HRD to the UGC, and now UGC is asking all the universities to observe this day.
Shirin, also any word there, any kind of clarification there being issued by any personnel of the UGC, considering the fact that the former Commission Secretary R.K. Chauhan has also confirmed, and I quote, that issuing a binding order to the university is not in accordance with the UGC Act, clearly saying that the UGC is not in its right to really impose a certain advisory. Any word there coming in from the UGC, or any kind of clarification there being issued?
sources within the UGC have been saying that this is not really our diktat. We have asked the universities and colleges to observe this day following the letter which has come from the ministry. So clearly we are seeing UGC is kind of trying to wash their hands off this responsibility. At the same time, they are also saying that only we can ask them to request universities to observe this day. But this binding order that has been come up by the HRD ministry, now they have asked all the colleges and universities to observe this birth anniversary of Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel. So clearly there is a confusion. You know, the UGC is also maintaining that we don't want to get into any controversy. We will be putting this notice. It's up to the university if they want to do it or not. This is a source-based information, but we have to wait and watch. Will this controversy now erupt following if whether the universities will actually observe this day?
Right. Many thanks, Shirin, for giving us all those details on that UGC diktat that has certainly raised eyebrows, now asking to mark the Unity Day. More importantly, they're asking all the universities to mark the Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel anniversary. That has sparked a major row because it is a body that has really, it gives advisories. Now it has made it mandatory for educational bodies to follow the orders.